What's up, y'all?
Come get this commentary.
The best on these streets. I'm about to start the club up.
What's up, everybody? Welcome back to the channel. I'm Kiva of Come Get This Commentary. And if you've been following this scandal, she is now she turned to the Lord. Okay, they all do. When you get caught scamming, you always run to God. Okay. And I'm for the Lord. So don't take that as run to God as being funny, but they use that as I did wrong, I'm gonna turn to the Lord. But people are about to get their justice because it's just been handed down what her retribution and payment will be. So she makes this post about God came to set the captive free. He set my man free from self-sabotage, regret, and shame, from the living in the past and who I was. So meaning, y'all know what I did. I was a scammer, but I have since turned unto the Lord, okay? And don't talk about me. Let's get into the story. So we're about to get into the news clip. This will give you a quick kind of synopsis of what she did, how she did it, and what the outcome. And you're going to hear from one of her customers as well.
I just finished filming a home workout for you guys.
By 2014, Brittany Dunn Davis had become a social media fitness influencer.
Kind of resonated with me just because it's something I've dealt with in my past.
Corey Reale had just started using Instagram and decided to buy Davis's fitness and nutrition plan.
I gained between 8 to 9 pounds that first week, which is detrimental to somebody who has battled eating disorders.
Despite a promise for personal coaching, Davis replied to Reale's concerns with generic affirmations.
I started to feel those red flags pop up, and I just had to literally make the decision. It's I'm done.
Last year, the Texas AG's office sued Davis for deceptive business practices, asking for up to $1 million, claiming she sold plans without personalizing them and even charged shipping fees for digital plans.
I'm sorry for anyone that feels hurt or scammed.
The case has now been settled, with Davis agreeing to pay $400,000. Another $130,000 can be added on if she violates the agreement, which bans her from selling personal plans without providing coaching and claiming to have special eating disorder knowledge.
I believe I read that 4 times just to make sure I was reading what I was reading.
Reale says years later, it feels like there's finally accountability.
I'm not trying to get my $90 back. It was never about the money for me.
Davis, who didn't respond to a request for comment, has to close her business, which she's already pivoted to spiritual content.
Fitness and health are no longer my identity. My identity is in Christ.
She's now selling Christian retreats.
If you've been following my story about Denia Jackson and Derrick Jackson, who does that sound like, huh? Scamming with the Lord, overpriced sessions and retreats. Okay, but carry on.
For up to $300.
Be cautious, honestly, because a scammer is a scammer is a scammer.
In Dallas, I'm William Joy.
Woo child, look at that pivot from scammer, from liar. How dare you play with people's eating disorders? You know, all of it's horrifying, right? Because people really are on their weight loss journey or maintaining their weight, right? But an eating disorder is so damaging and detrimental. It's psychological, it's mental, it's the whole nine. And you play with people on their health, that you could help them either fix it, get through it, or whatever it was. That was so fine. And those people were absolutely sick of her. They even came and started a petition. It only got up to approximately 16,000. I think this was back in 2019. But that's what you need to do sometime. You have a mass audience and you're taking people's money. You're promising them things that you can't come through with. You're messing with people's real life health and real life, in real time. That's a problem. And I think we're going to get into it in the next clip or so. She said something like, I had too many orders. Girl, it was just a mess. But I'm very happy that people spoke up and that people are actually getting their justice and getting some resolution. Because this was over 2 to 3 years in a court battle, and a lot of people came forward. So her pivoting over to the Lord, of course, that, pleases those. You got to trusting God, and God says to turn the other cheek and forgive. Yeah, I can forgive you, but I'm not going to forget, and I would never trust her again. It would be years if that was the case. And then we head on over to another article that actually spoke, I didn't even remember this, that she wanted people to sign an NDA because they were asking for a refund, and she was trying at every cost to protect her reputation that was being dragged through the mud for something she legitimately did. Paige, she actually came out, Paige Larson, she emailed and asked for a refund, and she said, well, only if you're going to sign this NDA for confidentiality moving forward. I got to protect my name and my brand in any future situation online. In order to get your refund, you got to do this. Well, it says she signed it. She sent it along with her PayPal information and proof of purchase as requested. But David still didn't respond to her, didn't send her back her money or anything. And this is the email, you can pause to read it, that Paige had sent her demanding that she sign it to even get her refund. Child, this was just a hot ghetto mess. Let's get into more of the article. She goes by the name of Brittany Dawn. She's like this Bible thumper, and she like changed her life, so to speak. God is love, go hug a tree. But she was into fitness, okay? So she got sued. They came down on her hard. So now she's agreed to pay $400,000 in deceptive trade lawsuit, okay? Brittany Dawn is a self-described fitness influencer, and she's agreed to pay $400,000 to settle a Texas lawsuit because they came for her, okay? Accusing her of scamming thousands of consumers through promises of customized diet and exercise plans. The fitness influencer turned Christian. She scammed them, saying that she was going to create these fitness plans and nutritional plans, okay? Brittany Dawn, the influencer from North Texas, who the Texas Attorney General's office claimed in a lawsuit, her social media followers came together and said she's a thief, okay, has agreed to pay $300,000 in civil penalties and $100,000 in restitution, according to the court documents. Davis admits wrongdoings, but says she was overwhelmed by the number of customers who purchased programs from her website. So essentially saying, I could do it, but I got too many people. I got too many response. Okay. Davis agreed and the state agreed on this settlement on April 25th, according to the letters. She got 3 years to pay her penalties and restitution, and will not be required to pay $131,000 in attorney's fees that were levied against her if she complies with the permanent injunctions included in the documents. The court documents say the settlement does not prevent private citizens from filing lawsuits against Davis. She was accused in the Deceptive Trade Practices Act lawsuit filed by the Texas Attorney General back in February of 2022 for scamming her followers, subscribers, and therefore from Instagram, YouTube, TikTok, where she falsely advertised that she would sell them customized fitness and nutrition plans, according to the suit. Davis charged her customers anywhere from $92 to $300 for these plans. But the lawsuit alleged Davis actually only provided generic plans to most customers. Some customers reported in the complaint that the diet plans they were sent did not contain adequate nutrition, and 14 noted that they chose Davis's plan because she had eating disorders and something she promised she had special training to address, according to the lawsuit. So people who deal with eating disorders in real life and are struggling and trying to get on track and do better, she fed into that, and she used that and got money out of people dealing with real life health issues, nutritional issues. Instead, the customer said the plans worsened their eating disorder. Shameful. Under the settlement, Davis agreed to permanent injunctions that prevent her from selling personalized nutrition or fitness assessments, reassessments, coaching check-ins, or workout plans unless she will actually provide them. Who's going to trust her after this? Okay. She's also prohibited from claiming to have any special knowledge or training to address eating disorders unless she has actually acquired it. Okay. She cannot charge shipping fees for products delivered digitally through email. What? A shipping fee for a PDF? Girl, that was a red flag right there. If Davis at any point fails to comply with the permanent injunction, she will be required to immediately pay the full amount due in penalties and restitution along with the attorney's fees. So as long as she act right, do what she's supposed to do over the next 3 years, keep up with her payment plans, she won't have that additional lawyer's fee. Okay, so the lawsuit started in 2019 after largely ignoring her customers' complaints that had shown up on her social media platform. She had also posted a video apologizing to her 250,000 YouTube followers, in which she read a statement from her phone apologizing for any
harm that I caused. I apologize to anyone who feels like they got scammed from me. I was not only a coach, but also the sole content creator, customer service, business owner, YouTuber, financial advisor, and everything else that comes with every business. I now realize that I should have had more help and that this is a lesson that I am having to now learn the hard way. And for that, again, I am. When you're given an opportunity like this, you would be stupid not to take it and run with it. And unfortunately, I ran too fast for one person.
Website. And said in a video that she needed more help running the program and would give the customers refunds. Davis also apologized on Good Morning America, according to FAA TV, that she was doing the best that I can to the best of my ability. She continued to post fitness and diet advice to her approximately 1 million TikTok followers and 500,000 on Instagram. So she still was running around here causing chaos and giving out false hope and wrong nutritional information. Now, changing the subject, more recently as a spiritual influencer, okay, out here doing the devil's work, Davis has organized Christian retreats, including one in Fort Worth, which was in April, okay, of 2022. The tickets were $125 a piece. Ooh, honey, it's a sucker born every minute. You hear me? She advised that the event was as a gospel-centered day with God-fearing women, according to her new website. The price for the retreat this April went up to $600. According to Don's other website, shelivesfreed.co, the price was a non-refundable deposit for the two-day retreat in Broken Bow, Oklahoma. The shelivesfreed.co website also accepts donations. It says it goes to funding events and a once-a-year private retreat for victims of human trafficking. On her website, she sells a spiritual devotional book for $29.99, advertising in the description that if customers want a physical copy, they can have it printed and bound at a printing or office supply store. So you're going to sell me a digital book for $30 and then tell me if I want to put it in print, I got to pay more money on my own at an office supply store to have them put it in book. Oh, okay. She also sells photo fillers and she calls presets on the website. And the prices range from $12 to $35. On a blog, Davis' website includes entries about Starbucks, a plant-based diet, and her favorite Bible passages. Through the last post dated January the 9th on her social media, she's changed the subject of her post from nutrition and fitness to spiritual because you were scamming the girls. So now you're going holy roly in order to take the shine off. You are a scammer, but you're going to be a healed scammer in the name of the Lord, I guess, because you're going to stick to your word, pay everything back in 3 years and not scam anyone. So now your new scam is religion. This is just my alleged opinion, okay? On her Instagram accounts, her posts include videos about how scary movies can invite demonic activity as the gatekeeper into your home, updates about fostering children, and photos and videos that include Bible verses. Her YouTube account includes vlogs about a miscarriage she had, Christian sex advice. Interesting, because you got to make Christian babies, okay? You got to bang it out, stop swallowing in order to make Christian babies. That's a fact. Housing foster children.
Well, get ready with me as I prepare for our next foster care placement. I was literally at a coffee shop getting some work done, and I got two phone calls, and our whole world just changed. That's how quick it happened.
Just like clockwork, not even 48 hours after you got this child placed into your home, you're already posting them on social media. And if nobody's picking up on the reasons as to why this particular placement is of concern, at least in my opinion, keep on watching. Yeah, you're reading that right. Before any of her stands come up in here, yeah, that's his name right there. So there is a reason as to why people would be concerned, at least in my opinion, like I said. What we're seeing with Brittany Dawn and her husband is the prime example of how the system is failing these children, and you can argue with your mother about it.
And addressing accusations of a scam involving a GoFundMe started by Davis and her husband for a man experiencing homelessness. Listen, you in another scam? I didn't know about that one. I may have to look into that.
Brittany Dawn, Snark Talk here. Just when you think things couldn't get any crazier and you couldn't hear any more absolutely batshit things about this abhorrent human, the story gets better, aka worse. So back in 2021, Brittany adopted, abducted, trafficked, many words for what she did, for a homeless man, an adult homeless man named James, who she's posted about all over her Instagram, all over her TikTok, completely infantilized, completely talked down to, and raised money for. It, the whole story starts like this. She claims this man walked into her Christian church and tried to donate his last pennies for the collection plate on Sunday. And that touched her Jesus-loving heart. And her husband decided to then take him to go get a shower, get his hair cut, buy him new clothes in this somewhat creepy, pretty woman-ish clothing haul montage where she talks down to him like he's a child of some kind. Whatever, peripherally, like, you know, nice thing to do. This seems nice. Like, she's not a great person, but like that act of helping out someone who's going through a tough time, nice. Until it gets crazy. Brittany and her husband set up a GoFundMe account claiming that they're going to help this man get drug and alcohol rehabilitation at an inpatient facility in, I believe, Ohio. She raises $25,000. Like, yay, amazing. People have been touched by this story. Like, what a beautiful display of Christ love and, you know, Jesus-like empathy and compassion for a person who's currently suffering. Well, the facility they end up sending him to is a free pro bono state-run crazy Christian rehab facility where there's not really doctors. There's people making you do like forced labor as a way to try to get you through the withdrawals of alcohol, opioids, whatever it is you're currently going through. And people have died. People have lodged complaints. It's a whole thing. But lo and behold, all that's to say, this is a free like facility. It doesn't cost anything. At most, Brittany and her husband spent a couple $100s on maybe flights and a hotel for the night for this guy while transporting him to this facility. They raised $25,000 in a GoFundMe. When James, this man, got out of rehab, he heard that there was money set up for him. He tried to contact Brittany and her husband to get this money, and they blocked him, and he has never heard from them again. A couple months later, Brittany and her husband booked expensive wedding venues and threw a lavish yet deeply tacky wedding. People are just, you know, putting two and two together and realizing that money they raised for a homeless man most likely went towards paying for her wedding. What the fuck?
In YouTube videos, TikToks, and posts on Reddit, people have questioned where the money was going, and many pointing out that the rehab facility where Davis and her husband sent the man, identified only as James, was free. In a response video the couple posted on YouTube, Brittany Davis's husband, Jordan Davis, okay, confirmed the facility was free and the money was given to James as spending money because the rehab doesn't provide money for cigarettes, for sure. They don't provide money for clothing, and they put a roof over your head and give you food, and they put you through their Christian ministry. So people thought they were giving him money to pay for him to go to a rehab. It turned out it was a free rehab. And then they had to come back and say, no, we gave him all this money we raised for a couple of squares and some bologna sandwiches, okay, and some clothes on his back. The couple and the woman who said she was James' sister mentioned in a video that James picked the rehab facility because he wanted to be able to smoke. The GoFundMe page titled Bless James Obedience has been taken down, but screenshots show at one point they received over $25,000 on that GoFundMe. GoFundMe said in an email statement to Telegram that the platform took down a fundraiser after it received complaints. The platform confirmed Davis and her husband were authorized by the beneficiary to withdraw the funds, but GoFundMe was not able to confirm the money was properly delivered to James, the beneficiary. We have systems in place allowing anyone to report a fundraiser if they have unanswered questions or concerns, the statement stated. After receiving reports about the fundraiser, our trust and safety team requested proof of delivery of the funds from the fund organizer. When the fund organizer, Brittany and her husband, failed to respond, interesting. So they asked, show us that you delivered this $25,000 to this man. They did not respond. The fundraiser was removed and they banned them. Okay. This story was posted January 8th, 2023. Yes, I am late to it. However, the update was June 11th. So let me know if you've heard of Brittany and her deceptive ways. What do you think, honey? The scams continue. The scams go on. But hopefully she will learn her lesson. But now she's turned to the good Lord, as most do when they get caught scamming and scam you with the word. So be safe out there. Bye.
Get this commentary.